President Greg Lamont.
Hello.
Thank you.
I'm really honored to be here. My wife, Kathy.
Yeah.
He's tired. He's tired.
Not in a good mood.
I don't blame him. Well.
You have the driver.
Why don't we get it?
So this is a big honor for me.
You've honored all of us. We're all very proud of you.
Thank you.
I just figured out, I did a little pencil. You averaged about 23 miles an hour.
Yeah. All right. I have a jersey I'd like to present you. This is the yellow jersey from the Tour de France. It's the what I wore last week, and they give it each day to the leader of the Tour de France. And I know you won't be able to wear it. But
well, thank you very much. Okay, nothing there for you. See?
Yeah.
There. Thank you.
Thank you for taking the time to honor me.
Something Jeffrey would like.
A little souvenir of the office of Jefferson Cobb.
Oh, wow.
Now, this is a bookmark that is also a souvenir in case
thank you
had to put the book down. Now, I don't know whether he's up to this or not, but in here is a with the seal engraved on it is a jar. Which is filled with jelly beans.
That's great.
You love that.
In case you insist on trying and you don't want to open it on the way, that's a sample of what's in the jar.
Great. Are they ever a mess? I said, and are they ever a mess?
You want to see the jelly beans?
Thank you very much.
Can you say thank you?
Well, listen, thank you.
Thank you. I hope to see you again.
I hope so. Thanks again. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm very proud.
Bye-bye.
Here we go, King.
My joy and gratitude over being home, home with my family, both physical and spiritual. I'm about to meet with the president later, to whom I shall convey the confidential message from my captors. This completes my mission. I've met with His Holiness the Pope, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and now I'm meeting with President Reagan. I'm not a politician, I'm a pilgrim. I believe, nevertheless, that there is a resolution to the tragedy of Lebanon that is based on our common belief in an almighty God. I appeal to those who held me captive, to those still holding Tom, Terry, and David, to end this situation. The best way they can do this would be to accept the invitation of Mr. Terry Waite to continue the dialogue aimed at resolving the situation. He is a churchman, a man who knows the thinking of those in authority, both the Catholic and Anglican Church. It must be resolved soon. Our common beliefs dictate this. Our humanity demands it. I pray for those being held captive. I also pray for my happiness. I thank you.
Father Jenco, is there anything at all that you think the president could do to be helpful?
Talk about that now.
Do you have any more or less hope for the release of your brothers, given the fact that you were released?
For 19 months, I lived with faith, hope, and love. I shared for many, many months together with these men, faith, hope, and love. We never gave up hope.
Mr. President, do you have any reason for optimism? Do you have any reason for optimism, Mr. President?
I know it's optimistic. You'll have faith and prayer. Evidence of it.
That's an airplane.